Here we go, guys. Exciting time is here. We are making finally in the video, previous week video, we make pattern for Olson type or duck nose mask, which is created, a pattern created by Florida University. I simplify that for you because they just have pamphlet on a website we can print out. If your phone don't work with your old printer or you simply don't have printer, you will be not available to make that pattern. No, well, that's why I make video for you simply, and I change a little bit that pattern, and it's still good because my changes was working good, because when I try and I check this mask what I make already by that original pattern and a little bit improved in full four layers of whole yard fabric, medical fabric, special medical fabric, we come up with and I check it with my cover. I will explain to you next week video. Subscribe what you will not miss it, how to check efficiency of your mask. Maybe silly method, but it's work. I check already six masks with that method, and this is the one which is best, and this is only DIY do by yourself make homemade mask, which is proved by a special experiment in a special hospital with special equipment. It does work the same way as N95. It passed the same test what N95 passed. That's why we spend so much time when I spend so much time for you to learn how to make it, because this is the best DIY mask ever made, and we have to spread it around because this pandemic is just in the beginning of it. It's not even second wave yet. No, well, that's what it is. And after we cut whole yard fabric, by the way, that video what I'm talking about, that making pattern, I'm attaching to the right above my token white line. Click on it. This will take you to making pattern for making this mask. You can do it from this material. You don't have it. Do from a shopping bag, because it's going to be the same polypropylene fabric on your like Walmart blue shopping bag, you know those ones. Cut it if you don't have money to buy that. Cut the shopping bag and make your mask. Or you can make just with from fabric with little filter inside, whatever you choose. It's still good pattern, very good fit to do that. But what they make from whole yard, and I'm making same whole yard, and that's the one exactly what pass test. And another white line above my token, click right now. It's going to take you to another video of Mike where to get this whole yard fabric. It's really not that expensive. And there's still plenty of them online. And sorry, try to talk faster. And you will know how to get it. And if you don't see those white lines right away, get back to my channel in 24 hours, because it takes YouTube about 24 hours to upload those white lines or cards what we're talking about. No, here we go. I'm preferring to do four layers. I don't know, maybe I did not read website very well on a Florida mask, Florida University mask, how many layers they use for that mask when they check it. But I'm sure it's no less as four. And because this fabric been checked on a germ resistance, it was not actually study made separate for virus resistance. But I do believe as many layers you have on anything, any kind of filter, as better, better protection against virus. Why? Again, click in another video right now above. It's only 3 minutes, and and my video explained to you exactly filters work by improvement by putting one on another and why it's happening. Only 3 minutes video. Click on it, and it will take you to that such a simple common sense explanation. Well, I prefer to take four layers of it, and that's your pattern. Remember, we had places to sew ties, and we places for darts. No, well, draw those places on this material already, like that, and draw darts where it goes, just like that. Now, you have to make ties. What you do? You cut, find a t-shirt. If you don't own one, buy in a thrift store or somewhere in garage sale. Well, it has to be at least 95% cotton and at least 5% of spandex. Why? Because spandex make more stretchable and much more comfortable and weightless. Well, what you do, cut half inch wide like I have right here, and then stretch it out, completely stretch it out, pull it as far as you can, and that's what you come up with. How long these ties should be? Well, what you do, you actually, let me just move it this way, what you can see better. And what you do, you just cut this tie. Can be just one layer and you double it or two of them, and measure around your head, because these ties will go around head just like N95 will go all around your head. One around neck, another around your head on the back. No, well, that's what you do. Measure, just kind of don't have to be, put it over your head, this, make sure it's fit you free. Don't have to be exactly, because we will adjust after all. As you can see, I adjusted here after I make mask, but at least about what you will know that will be not too short, because go through all that and sew ties together inside and then figure up what is too short, that will be a bummer. No, well. Okay, now what you do? Put your ties like that. This one, this is marking place for those ties. It's going to be somewhere there. Put one going here, another going right here somewhere. And then it's under one layer. You have three still under. Put it right here like that. Make sure this ties is going exactly where it's supposed to go, where your mark is. Pin that way, what it's not moving. And the same here. Don't do nothing about darts yet. Just work with your ties. Make sure it's there. Pin it. And do the same here, obviously. And after you pin it, kind of put all that together, mask. Just kind of pin it what it will be not movable, because we start stitching after this. Okay, now guys, I went for close-up, because now it's about stitching and you can see better. You pin what I just told you. Now what you do, put this ties inside, get off your way like that, make sure put here, pin here what it will not got on your way whatsoever, and start stitching. My heart going after those ones who do not have sewing machine or don't know how to sew. No, well, in same time when we making mask, I still want you to have this best mask we ever made. That's why I'm showing to you how to do it by hands. Just beginning, how to do this hand stitching as good as machine stitching by hands. And later on I will finish up with machine, obviously. Just a few minutes to spend for those who don't sew and want to learn how. You get embroidery needle instead regular one. Why? Because it does have I try to get to camera as close as possible. It does have huge quarter inch wide hole, special embroidered needle, easy to stick thread to. Stick thread to it, double it, and look how easy to make. You just one time to wrap around your finger like that, and you slide it with twisting. You got your knot, no problem at all. Start stitching from a half inch above, at least like maybe 3/4 inch above this dot what you mark, quarter inch from the end. But make sure if you cut uneven for somehow, it's fine. I'm calling everybody, stop being perfect, because none of us never been perfect and never will. Only God is perfect. None of us is. No, well, keep in mind, as early you learn in life what you cannot be possible perfect, as better your life will be. And, well, if it's something not even over there, make sure whenever you're stitching, you're catching all four layers. Again, begin 3/4 from this dart again. And that's how you do it. And make about quarter inch wide stitching. And let me just pass this first tie. What I will show to you how to make it the stitching as good as machine ones. For now, you're doing just quarter inch stitching and quarter inch from the very end. Make sure you got inside that tie. Inside, because remember when we pull it, it's become very narrow. Make sure you make sure at least twice you got inside, what it's not going to pop up on you. And you pass it. And obviously you go like that, all way around right here. Not here. Don't stitch this one. This is for turning it out. All way here and stop like 3/4 before another dot. And what you do after you done that way, you turn your job around and go opposite way and close these gaps between quarter inch stitching with your stitching now. Like that. Make sure at least one time you got in that tie, which is make already 3 stitching through, that should hold it, even if you do by hands, okay? And make sure you closed up these gaps, what you have before between quarter inch stitching. You're closing that up when you're going backwards. And look what you got. You got good, nice, solid stitching because of you on both sides. because of your double thread, that should hold. All that together, you see my dart here. Make sure it shows on another side as well. Now, well, this is one of your darts. This is another one. And this is one more. Draw that. Don't have to be perfect, okay? Do the same with another one. And after that, what you do? This is your turning point under this, where is your ties? That's your turning point. Now, well, what you do? You make sure what you, your dart will be on one layer right here, stitch like that. And another three layers together, your dart stitch like that all together. Just like that. Okay, darts is ready. Now you still have to stitch something story to make sure it's gonna be bent, this mask gonna bend perfect around your nose. Before in my mask I was using those ties, you know, like for food packages ties or bread packages ties. This time I decided to use something wider. It's about 1/4 inch wide because it's much more story because those ones is gonna be twist back and forward. You have to reinforce them before you turn mask inside out by hands, what they're not good. Sometimes they pop out and wash it. This one will not pop out on you. And what it's come from? It's come if you buy garbage bags in a store, in the packages. Separate, you can buy ties to go with those garbage bags. And that's what it is. And it's about 3-3.5 inches between those two ties. Somewhere there, stitch it. It's 1/4 inch. And that our seam exactly 1/4 inch there. And you stitch it there. Okay, now when it's tied, it's there. Darts is there. Stitch it the rest of the way, all the way to this corner. Rest of the way, all the way to this corner. Now when it's all stitched, cut these little corners. If you meet any imperfections there, some seams don't come together exactly, like in my case, don't worry, stitch a little bit more far. That the genius is, again, I'm calling for imperfections because, you know, we can commit our life to make everything perfect. And, well, this mess created so geniusly by that lady doctor. I'm sorry I forgot her name. But she geniusly made that weight. She tried to repeat as doctor, knowing also mask shapes very well because she's working with them. And well, she creates this mask so perfect, but even little imperfections here and there, it's totally gonna work for you guys. Trust me, I already did a few of them. And if you're making for your kid, just step a little bit more inside. I forgot to tell you, set 1/4 inch on the end, make like 1/2 inch in, and that's how you run seam. After all that done, turn inside out. Okay guys, my very fast and sloppy job end up with this thing right here, not even. These three layers come up even more or less, and this one is not even right here. I will get more close to you. Guess what? That's why I named channel perfect, not perfect, granny. Just cut it, make it even like that. Not big deal. I never want you to worry about it. You have better things to worry about it, more important ones. And now you can just put it together. Whatever side is look better to you, that dart looking better. For me, I believe it's this side. That's gonna be face. It's mean you turning like that. And you stitch it one more time right here again, 1/4 inch away from that. Okay, after you turn it and stitch it and turn it, I come up with this kind of heart shape. And, well, try it on, because I did it on a purpose, all these pattern changes. It's going to fit as many people as possible, as good as possible. And what you do, try it on. And I'm a big woman size-wise, but my actual face is small. No, well, most of women have smaller face. No, well, this part of it is kind of sticking out of my chin way too far away, and it's kind of created gap over there. What I do? I go back to my seam, and what I do, I stitch it like in my case, it's almost 1 inch in, and I stitch it this way. This way. Don't cut nothing yet. Try it again. Try it over and over and over on you and get to the point when it's lay very good around your nose. Bend it, of course, whenever you need to bend it here. And laying very good under your chin, around your cheeks, no gaps around when you cut. And regulate by taking in here if you need to tie it up, okay? Regulate it by taking in here. After you're done with that, you cut it and you stitch it that flat. Here we go, guys. We got our famous Florida University face mask from whole yard material, famous because it's only one who passed the same test as N95 mask. And as you can see, it's very awesome because of shape of it, follow shape of your of N95. Very awesome looking mask and very, very much duck nose look like. That's another name for awesome type of masks. And well, maybe it's look a little bit funny, but it does good job. And it's very light. And when you're taking in under chin in this area, like I told you, well, make sure you're not taking too far, just like about 1.5 inches up and all the way down. And the rest is give you all that space. Give you all the space when you what you wear in your mask, it's actually sticking out like that, follow shape of N95, because you need that space between your nose and mouth and end of mask to give you that freedom to breathe. That's what's good about this mask. And well, I started this with hand stitching just to make sure what those people who don't know how to sew know how to do that as well. And I finished with hand stitching. As I can see, I flattened down. I stitched that seam. I stitched that seam down, but it's still not bothering me from inside by hands as well. And also I stitched around, as you can see, all this mask, just one stitching, 1 millimeter. On the very end of this mask, as you can see, 1 millimeter stitching going all around this mask. And it probably will be hard for you to do this stitch without a sewing machine, unless you know how to use a thimble. No, well, right now about my talking, another white line. If you don't see it, come back to video in about 20 hours, it will be there. It took about usually that long YouTube to download it, those cards or white lines, what we call on the top of screen. And I will put another video above my talking right now, how to sew with thimble and which thimble better to use and why. And it's actually very easy if you know what you're doing. Well, another video will guide you right through it. And please subscribe. And we are investigating our first mask from 44 or 41, I forgot already, approved by 60 approved masks by 64 hospitals. And we go and checking out all of them, quality and easy, how to make it easy or not. No, well, that's what I will commit probably another month to do it, maybe like one or two. This is most long one because I had to make pattern. For other ones probably will be more easy. I will not even teach you how to make pattern unless I make already mask and I like it the same what I like this one. More is 128 video on each, on only 5 months on 5 months old channel. Please subscribe and go and check it out. All kind of sewing tips there on topic of pandemic, and it's not. For those subscribers of mine who stick with me because of style suggestions or just simply sewing suggestions outside this pandemic topic, well, another video for you coming in by weekend. And well, subscribe and put that bell button, like it, because if you put like, it will bring a video up in the search, and that's good, because we need to spread this ways of making masks, because it's easy, it's really good. I even gave few to my doctor, and she really liked it. And as you can see, top going overhead, I did not have to adjust size, but one going around neck, I have not. It's my adjustment. It's as long as it's going over your head and go on your neck, you can put any knot adjustment on the top if original thought what you put on was too big. Okay, guys, thank you for watching, and see you next time. Thank you.